Welcome back to the stream, everyone. Today we're going to be playing a Monkey Island, which is a game which was released in gonna venture I guess and say 2011. I really hope there's some kind of summary. Yes, I would like Monkey Island 101 to be able to make changes to my computer. Oof. 2009. Very old game. Oh, that's loud. Audio settings. Alright, now I can hear my own voice and focus a little bit more. Actually, since I'm not going to be listening to anyone, I can have it up to a reasonable amount. Let me go to my video settings, graphic settings. 1680 by 1050. Apply. Quality highest. All right, so I've got it all set up. Hello, that's the best way you could have introduced yourself. Welcome to Telltale's Tales of Monkey Island. Hopefully, we get a summary of what's happening, otherwise I will have to explain a very rough four games, which isn't actually that hard. Also, I haven't touched this game in, like, 5 years. So we're going to be solving these puzzles together. And experiencing what happens in this game together, because I only remember very big story beats. Not age as well as I had hoped.
The legendary 13th monkey of Montevideo. Whose sacrifice will eternally bind the oceans themselves to my infernal will. Depressed yet?
Not half as much as I'll be when Guybrush guts your diseased carcass with his voodoo cup, doddering sack of scum.
I wouldn't hold your breath waiting for any last-minute heroics, me dear. The last I saw of your mighty pirate husband, he was being torn apart by a school of my ravenous piranha poodles.
All right, LeChuck, put down. down the monkey and back away from my wife.
Guybrush!
All right, the writing apparently is consistently good with Threepwood. I think it's just Dominic Armato's voice, though.
And the seas will run red with the blood of my enemy. Har, har, har.
Yeah, well, you fight like a...
No time to waste, Guybrush. Finish enchanting that sword before LeChuck completes his spell.
I'm on it. One LeChuck defeating cursed cutlass of Kafloo coming up. Now, where did I leave those handy voodoo instructions?
They're pinned to your mast.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, here we are actually in the game. Let me turn on subtitles first. So I guess we don't get a summary. You are playing Guybrush Threepwood, famed mighty pirate. Not Taco, but very good. Let me turn this audio down. This is much louder than I thought. Wait, now I can hear myself think. Yeah. Firstly, excellent score. Very good soundtrack. You are playing Guybrush Threepwood. The zombie dude is his arch-nemesis, LeChuck, who you've killed a lot of times in various forms across the past four games. And that is your wife, Elaine, who has been talking to you. And that's, I think, most of what you need to know. It's a point-and-click adventure game, also.
Come to Guybrush, you sneaky voodoo recipe you. Well, I had to sail six of the seven major seas to find the ingredients, but I finally finished the cutlass. Almost. Now all I need to do is find some fizzy root beer to spray on it, and LeChuck's as good as toast. Mickey's disease toast.
Alright. What? These controls are so weird because they're camera relative, but the camera constantly changes.
Elaine thought I was an idiot for buying the auto navigation option. Who's the idiot now, huh?
I guess you just click.
Legendary monkey casket of Kauai. Never forget the horrible hula of Hades I had to do to get this thing. Is this thing sloshing? More words you don't want to hear when you pick up a coffin.
Alright. This is my inventory. I'm going to inspect it.
How you open this thing? Aha! A seltzer bottle full of root beer. I haven't seen one of these since before I had a beard. Bet this stuff will work wonders on my cutlass.
You used a, what was it? You used a root beer in the first game.
What is a seltzer bottle doing in a monkey coffin anyway?
Alright, we're gonna take the seltzer bottle, we're gonna take this, we're gonna combine them.
Alright, time to give this cutlass a root beer shower. Flat root beer? What kind of second-rate voodoo seltzer bottle has flat root beer?
Fun fact. The intent to make a game for or a movie out of this is what inspired the first Pirates of the Caribbean. Alright. Plans to combine them.
Elaine, my beautiful butter!
What?
I said, Elaine, my beautiful butter!
My beautiful butter?
I was gonna say buttercup, but you keep cutting me off!
Oh, Guybrush. Now stop the chuckle, we're all dead.
Root beer's flat.
Root beer's flat!
Then find something to fizz it up! Chuck hijacked my ship and sailed to the Rock of Gelato to finish his terrifying voodoo ritual. It's a good thing we've got the Cutlass of Kafloo on our side, or we'd be done for.
Are you alright?
Are you okay?
I'm fine! Finish the recipe!
Do you need anything?
I said I'm fine! Just finish the recipe!
Root beer's flat!
Oh yeah.
Then find something to fix it up!
I want to keep clicking this one.
Want me to get anything from the hold? I brought some pot stickers.
No! Finish the recipe!
Why do you keep shouting at me?
I'm not shouting! I'm projecting!
There we go. This is a very... This game does not control how I remember. Yay, fizzy root beer. Now we put the Voodoo root beer on the cutlass. She's extremely valid.
Prepare to meet your frosty carbonated maker, LeChuck.
Arr! Come and get me, a dirt digging doily dipper!
Stop showboating and spray the sword, Guybrush!
Not showboating, I'm.
Wonderful.
Okay, no problem. I just need to find a fresh supply of impossible to find voodoo root beer. I sure hope there's some on Elaine's ship, because mine's as dry as a bone. And not one of those wet bones. I'm talking a dry, dry bone.
He did say oop. A dry bone.
You can do it, sweetie!
Alright.
Elaine!
Throw me the rope.
Elaine, you've got inordinately strong thighs. See if you can swing me that rope.
It's not long enough.
Oh, they are married by this point. I forgot that. They got married in the third game, I think.
How'd you do that?
You don't spend several years at the side of Guybrush Threepwood, naughty pirate,
TM.
For a few tricks, darling.
My ship, my booty, my collection of autographed sextants.
We'll buy you some more sextants later. Just stop, LeChuck.
Ah, Threepwood. So good of you to join us. Saves me the trouble of having to sink your ship.
I'm really not here for his voice actor. Which I don't think is consistently his voice actor. Let me make this grog fizzy.
Fizzy low-cal grog. I bet I can make a fortune selling this to, well, no one.
Those Chuck the plant.
Really use a trim.
Let me take a cutlass. Go ahead and use Unchuck the plant.
Let's see if we can cut back some of those unruly roots. There. Much neater.
His name is Guybrush Threepwood Mighty Pirate TM. I just realized some parts of this game are going to be me explaining references to 1990s adventure
like
games. Not all of it, though. Just some of it. Alright.
Okay, you barrel of disgusting low-cal goo. Make yourself useful.
I made root grog, because it's root beer.
Booyah! Look
but
out, LeChuck.
It's grog instead.
Here comes Guybrush Threepwood's glowing sword of hot monkey vengeance.
Can I get out of the quarters?
I'll sleep when I'm dead. Or later tonight.
Monkeys!
Come on there, guys. We'll get you out as soon as I put an end to LeChuck.
Gunpowder.
Won't someone?
I wondered where all my gunpowder went after the mother-in-law incident.
I think that one's just a non sequitur. Alright, time to stab LeChuck.
LeChuck! Do you mind? I'd be in the middle of an unholy ceremony here.
Unholy this!
Unholy this?
Yeah, I know, but he didn't give me much to work with. Hey!
Arr, you can't defeat me that easily, sheep. Wait, what's happening? LeChuck.
What are you doing? Finish him!
It's not me, it's my hand. It won't.
Uh-oh.
Elaine!
Here we go.
Guybrush?
Aww. Monkey Island's opening is a very good song. There's our inciting incident. Something's wrong with Guybrush's hand, and also, the ship blew up. And Ron Gilbert's the dude that made Monkey Island and Grim Fandango, but doesn't write them anymore. I hope you like stock wind-blowing sound effect.mp3.
Ahoy there, me hearty!
What?
Don't worry, we'll have you up and sucking back a grog in... No! My dote! My beautiful pirate dote! I'll get you for this, you craven bilge rat!
Sorry, I don't know what got into me.
Oh, this can't be good.
You know, you really should have that looked at, kid.
Huh?
The name's Nipperkin. Davy Nipperkin. Senior reporter, Keel Hollow Gazette. Welcome to Flotsam Island. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Actually,
yeah. Great. What's your name, where'd you come from, and how'd you get here?
My name is not important.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Pirate, eh? I believe it when I see it, kid. Still, it'd be nice to have a real genuine pirate buckling his swash around Flotsam Island again. Why, I haven't had an honest-to-goodness pirate story to write about in over 6 months.
Right.
Yes, sirree, Bob. Nothing like the promise of a good pirate story to get the old journalistic juices flowing again, says
hey.
I. Say, just listen to me prattling on while you stand there all wet and confused and whatnot. So, what's your story, Creepwood?
I need to find a ship to get back to the lane.
This island looks, lovely, but where can I find a ship? I really need to get back to the Rock of Gelato and find my wife.
Well, there's only one ship here on Flotsam Island, but it won't do you any good.
Why not?
It's the winds, Threepwand. The winds. Here on Flotsam Island, the winds are always blowing inward 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. It's a freak of nature, a fluke, a curse. Whatever you want to call it, the result is the same. Once you've landed on Flotsam Island, you're trapped!
Are you seriously telling me there's no way off this island?
Well, not by ship, anyway. The only person who I think might know a way off the island is Deep Gut.
Deepthroatjoke.mp3. The Richard Nixon Deep Throat thing, not the sex joke.
Deep Gut? What's a Deep Gut?
Deep Gut's my secret source of off-island news.
I love
stories.
I will.
It's a good thing, too.
As soon as I see
without
her.
Without the Gut's uncanny inter-island scoops, the Keel Hollow Gazette would never be able to compete with those snooty prima donnas over at the Flotsam Times.
Off-island news? Hey, then he might know something about Elaine. Where can I find this Deep Gut?
Hold on a second, pirate boy. Davy J. Nipperkin doesn't go handing over his secret sources to every Tom, Dick, and Guybrush that washes ashore.
But I can pay you with treasure from my ship, which is probably at the bottom of the ocean by now.
Look, kid, you seem like a nice enough pirate, so I'll make you a deal.
All right. Love making deals.
A deal?
Yeah, off-island news is nice and all, but the fair citizens of Flotsam are getting tired of stories about faraway lands they'll never see again. Not to mention that I hate being beholden to this Deep Gut person.
So
I need some nice, meaty, local pirate news.
I love making pirate news.
That's the spirit, kid. You can translate that moxie into news-making pirate mayhem, and I'll hand you Deep Gut on a silver platter.
Yeah, this'll be a snap. A snap. A snap. Ow!
Alright, chapter one of, as you could probably assume by my games roster, 5 chapters. Examine this broken robot.
Well, that's not gonna work.
One of my favorite sight gags.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Utterly unfixable robot.
Well, that's not gonna work. Well, that's not gonna work.
I think that's the last one.
Well, that's not gonna work.
Yeah, fascinating yet pointless sea flotsam. I don't believe there's anything important on the beach, so now we're just exploring this island together.
Card?
Card? What card?
What is this a reference to?
Attention! Club 41, Flotsam Island's most prestigious pirate organization, is no longer accepting new applications for membership. Thank you for your continued interest, and please go away.
Got it. Here's a vat.
Printer's ink, the lifeblood of the newspaper industry, lovingly harvested from squid udders.
Squid udders. Alright.
Whoever built this jail really wanted to put the burr in Brig. Those eye carvings are creepy.
Pieces of these puzzles are coming to me in, like, flashes. Squatters. There's a big swordfish up there. Here's a boat.
Holy screaming starfish! I think I've just found my ride off this stinking island.
Not so fast, my well-coiffed friend.
Who?
Reginald Van Winslow, captain of the Screaming Narwhal. And you are?
Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Oh, really? What can I do for you, Mr. Mighty Pirate?
I think Van Winslow cannon by, but I'm not 100%. It could just be because he reminds me a lot of Sir Hammerlock. Tell me about Club 41.
Do you know anything about Club 41?
Club 41? Wonderful place. I haven't been there since I lost my membership card when I seized the narwhal.
Nice ship. Were you drunk when you built it?
Good one, boy.
They truly are.
But I didn't build the Screaming Narwhal. It was assembled by a committee of concerned Flotsam citizens.
Were they drunk?
No, but they had to use whatever floated ashore. Hence, the aforementioned constructed by Sod's Nook.
Fun fact, he is the barkeep in Poker Night of the Inventory.
Well, if you didn't build the narwhal, why are you the captain?
By tradition, whoever knocks the captain of the Screaming Narwhal off the deck gets to be the captain until he's knocked off by the next guy.
So all I have to do is knock him off, huh?
How'd I become
the captain? If you didn't build the narwhal, why are you the captain?
Oh, I think I just tradition. Went down that one.
Whoever knocks the captain of the How Screaming
do I skip
Narwhal
this?
Off the deck gets to be the captain until he's knocked off.
So while I...
Okay, right click, skips things. How'd you end up on Flotsam?
How'd you end up on Flotsam?
Same as everyone else here, lad. The winds! I was chasing some brigand that had stolen my hard-earned booty. When all of a sudden, Flotsam's capricious winds picked up my ship, shredded it to bits, and plunked me down here on her bounteous shores.
Alright, let's board this dude.
Strike your colors! I've come to seize your ship!
You have? Jolly good! No one's been man enough to take the Screaming Narwhal for over 2 years!
He's got a really good attitude for someone who's about to lose his ship.
Time to try and seize the ship.
Why are you so happy about me seizing your ship?
I love a good challenge. Girds the mind and sharpens the loins, don't you know?
Huh?
Don't say that.
Me
see bad.
I look forward to it.
Alright, let's go to this anchor chain.
Nothing more piratey than the old climbing up the anchor trick. Oh, dang.
You'll have to do better than that, lad.
Some good old hot coals. You know, like it be.
Prepare to be boarded, then, Winslow.
I remember how to do this now. Grease.
bacon grease, boyo. Slickest stuff in the seven seas.
Oh, crud. This jacket was an anniversary present. And now it's all covered with bacon grease. Man, is Elaine gonna be PO'd.
Now I go up the... Oh, hold on. I guess we're talking about
Screaming
Narwhal
may not be particularly pretty or seaworthy, but at least she's a ship.
I think the Screaming Narwhal looks neat. Alright, we're going up the anchor chain again. Do not put the hot coals in your mouth.
Dang.
Bad.
Hot, ow!
Now we've got a fire going.
And now the dock is smoldering. Perfect!
And I never ever do anything about the weather, because the weather never ever does a thing for me.
Alright, let's go inside. Because there's a doctor.
What a crummy sconce. I'd better pick this up before someone notices, trips over it.
Sconce time, baby. Oh, the doctor is busy, never mind.
I'm not sure whether this is late Rococo or early creepy.
Close up Guybrush running time, baby.
Alphabet sail!
Ahoy there, scruffy artisan. I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Ahoy yourself! I be Gaffer Crimpnidget, pirate glassblower.
Pirate glassblower.
What's this alphabet sail all about?
It's the latest thing. I make unbreakable tubes in the shapes of letters, which can be used to create festive illuminated business signs, novelty mementos, or lamps.
Kitschy.
Aye, very camp. Consonants cost 48 pieces of 8, but today I'm giving away one free vowel per customer. Would you like a vowel?
Give me a free vowel, please.
I think I'd like one of those free vowel tubes.
You'd like to buy a vowel, eh? Here you go.
A U? What about A, E, I, O, or even Y?
All sold out. All we got is U-tubes these days.
Was that a YouTube joke? I don't know. Wait, we're a big fish. Oh. The big fish we passed a while ago.
How'd a crusty pirate like yourself wind up making little glass unicorns?
Listen, matey. Glass blowing's every bit as dangerous as sailing the Spanish Main. One false move with your glass jack near the glory hole, and you can kiss your eyebrows goodbye.
I can? I'm not sure that's biologically possible. So, unicorns, huh?
Aye. Graceful, delicate creatures they are. Though, to be honest, they aren't selling so well to the pirate community at large. For my next project, maybe I'll be making something that really speaks to them. Assuming I can ever sell these blasted, horny buggers.
Alright,
thanks
farewell.
For chatting, but I got a wife and arch nemesis to return to.
Can I steal his
Aye,
horn?
Who does
his boys? These boys. Give
wow.
me one, please.
Never thought I'd see a pirate selling glass unicorns for a living.
Aye, and I never thought I'd see a talking baboon. So I guess we're even.
Alright, so the list of things we need to do is get into Club 41. What's this?
Pirates plundering your palace? Buccaneers bashing your balustrades? Swashbucklers slicing your stomachs? Then you
oh.
need Morgan Le Fay, pirate hunter par excellence. Great, a pirate hunter. I need that like I need a fourth nipple.
Anyways. We need to make some news, and we need to take the Screaming Narwhal. And first news... I could have sworn there was an actual map we were allowed to walk around.
Hi! Ah! Who are you? I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate. And you are?
Joaquin Jacinto de Mera Alfonso de Oro, treasure hunter extraordinaire.
What kind of treasure do you
what
hunt?
What kind of treasure do you hunt? Gold doubloons? Silver triploons?
Anyone can find gold or silver. I look for the rarest of pirate treasures.
I'm almost certain I'm going to regret asking this, but what is the rarest of all pirate treasures?
Porcelain power pirates.
What in the name of Davy Jones's closet organizer are porcelain power pirates?
They're the rarest and coolest action figures ever. I've been tracking them with the porcelain power pirate treasure maps hidden in special boxes of porcelain power pirate pear-flavored breakfast cereal. I've spent years tracking them down, and I've almost got the full set.
So he collects Power Rangers figurines.
Nothing.
It looked like you were playing with dolls.
They're not dolls. They're polyarticulated porcelain power pirates.
How many PP pirates do you have left?
The only power pirate I have not found is the ultra rare, impossible to find, Dark Ninja Dave with killer karate katana. I thought I might find it here on Flotsam Island, but I got scammed.
Scammed?
Jace, some guy in a plaid jacket with waving arms sold me a Ninja Dave map, but he just keeps sending me in circles.
You keep talking like that, and I'm gonna call it a PP pirate, Charlie.
What makes Dark Ninja Dave so rare?
Because a bunch of pirate parents have been banned on account of his pointy killer karate katana accessory. They said it was
pirate
a choking
parents.
Hazard. Wimps.
What makes Dark
Ninja
Dave?
Oh wait,
Dave
we just went that one.
Because a bunch.
Can I look at the map?
Mind if I take a look at that map?
Take it. It's useless.
I'll let you know if I find anything. You're sure this Dark Ninja Dave is a valuable treasure, right?
It's the stuff that dreams are made of. Porcelain dreams.
Bad. Oh yeah, Guybrush has a crippling fear of porcelain.
Did the wind shipwreck you on Flotsam Island too?
Yes, but I came here voluntarily in search of the elusive Dark Ninja Dave porcelain power pirate action figure.
What's that big pink pile of dolls?
Action figurines.
Okay, what's that big pink pile of action figurines over there all about?
Those are my extra pink pajama Pierres, the lamest and least valuable of the porcelain power pirates. I loathe pink pajama Pierre with the white hot intensity of a million exploding cannonballs.
Can I call you Doro the Explorer?
No.
Look! It's a Ninja Dave figure with throwing star action!
Where?
Mine.
Okay, Guybrush. It's only a little porcelain. Just close your eyes and go to your happy place. Ew.
I didn't see anything.
Sorry, must have been a leaf.
So now we've got an action figure. And the ability to get big lost in these woods.
Oh God.
Hence, this, which takes us just back to the jungle entrance. I believe, let me just wander around and see where everything takes us. Cool, the well.
I wish I were the mightiest pirate ever.
Arr, no!
Yikes.
Joke. This is not of the writing chops of Grim Fandango, you may have noticed.
According to this, it's Sunday, the 12th of Manatee.
Alright, let's head over here.
Curious.
I do appreciate that these games are made holistically. Wait, those were bombs. I want those.
Smilin' Stan's Young Miss Mini Bombs. All the punch of larger mini bombs packed into a smaller package for petite pirate hands. You know, I better just take all of them.
Yeah. So now I've got a whole bunch of bombs at some point. I should have bagel bites. So, still don't know what these are, I think.
Curious.
Yep, and we're not going to get an answer for a very long time. Fun fact, the old games used to have a lot of MacGuffins, what's the word? Items basically that you would just pick up to pick up and would never do anything, and that was their way of like increasing the challenge, and this game doesn't because they'd have to port those knowing that they would never use them across games.
What's the word?
I'm selling these fine leather jackets.
I'm selling these fine leather jackets.
Yeah. We don't know the word yet, but we'll know the word eventually. Where is this going to take us? This is going to take us to the hole. Okay. So this is the map of Flotsam. I know where the creepy shack is now. I don't even remember what these other areas were. What I do remember is that we have to, Skybrush sprinting around. To follow the loudest noise of the winds. There's an altar. Cool.
I wonder what sort of hideous sacrificial rites were performed on this ancient altar. Tastes like chicken.
Whoops.
Curious.
Oh, these do become relevant immediately. Not, like, super immediately, but... Oh, okay, I remember what those noises are also. Did we get the map from him? We did. Okay, let's look at Doro's map.
That jungle sure is noisy.
So, we gotta go to the well and then follow those noises. And the well is up here. I may have to eat soon, I apologize. Alright, so we used Doro's map at the well. And now we want to follow the noises of Warthog Monkey Bee, is where I'm gonna start. Whoops. Still remembering these controls. That's bird. That's nothing, apparently. Warthog.
So far, so good.
Ah. I keep hitting escape to get away from that.
Sure is noisy.
Alright. Monkey, and then bee time. Monkey, warthog, bee, bird. Bee, warthog, and the next one is going to be monkey, right?
That jungle sure is noisy.
Monkey, warthog, bee. Warthog? Just to be sure. Yes. That's monkey. That's bird.
Take that!
This is warthog.
This looks promising.
Bee bird?
That jungle sure is noisy.
Yeah, bee bird.
So far, so good.
Okay. There we go. Finally followed the map. X marks the spot.
Dang. Looks like someone already dug up this treasure.
But now we know how to get back to it later. Because there's a buried treasure. I will be right back. I gotta go eat. I will see you when I am back, friend. I'm back. Oh, hey. Yes, dinner good. It was, stir fry. It was very tasty. Alright, I'm gonna go kind of figure out what to do now.
Get your hand blown glass.
Let me go get my hands on the screaming narwhal.
And Dundee and the dead winds crashed you.
These things could knock a pirate on his or her rear.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good idea, but I should probably try lighting it first.
Let me try.
Sheer, sexy, and playful, with plenty of support for the active pirate.
Hmm. Got it. yeah, I can climb along this close. That's what I want.
Uh-oh.
All right. This is an elaborate time-based puzzle. We light this on fire using the grease fire.
Okay. Now what?
Now I take it and put it in the underwear. Such a good
movement. Good thing Winslow's undies have so much crotchal support.
And now I try to go up the clothesline. Here we go.
No, don't, please.
You'll have to be a lot sneakier than that if you want to knock me off, lad.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
What? Clever boy.
My ship now.
Well played, Master Threepwood. Or should I say, Captain Threepwood?
Captain?
Aye, now that you've bounced me off the screaming narwhal, you're officially its captain! Until someone else comes along and knocks you off.
Sweet!
Aye, bloody well sweet it is. Now if you'll excuse me, I have some massive internal hemorrhaging to attend to. Congratulations!
I just got a tip there's some kind of wanton piracy going on.
I don't know where he's going.
Not just any wanton piracy, a genuine ship seizure committed by none other than Captain Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate. Guybrush is one word.
Wonderful! I could probably get a week's worth of stories out of this. Well, keep up the swashbuckling, Threepwood, and I'll be forking over the secrets of Deep Gut in no time.
Alright, that's my ship. I cannot get onto it, but it's mine now.
Got a ship again. Now, if only these stupid winds would stop sucking, I could sail away and find Elaine.
Let's see if the doctor is ready. Yep. Me to knock.
Hello?
My spleen.
Yeah, I think I'll try again later.
Got it. Answer is not now.
Alphabet sail.
I guess court isn't in session today, which is probably a good thing considering all the laws I'll be breaking.
Be like that sometimes.
Hear ye, hear ye. Owing to the unprecedented downturn in criminal activity on Flotsam Island, I've locked up the courthouse and taken a long-delayed 3-month sabbatical. Please don't break any laws until I return, or else. Sincerely, Judge Grindstone.
What do we do? There should be cheese around here somewhere. I don't know where we get that.
Hey, Davey.
Call me Nipperkin, kid. Everyone else does.
I'd rather not. So, what sorts of swashbuckling do you go in for around these parts?
Oh, we used to love all sorts of piracy here on Flotsam. Barely a day would go by without a good bar fight. Ship seizing, a buried treasure cropping up. Now it seems like all anyone wants to do is hang around and wait for the winds to change.
Well, leave it to me, and your sleepy little hamlet will be bubbling over with buccaneering boisterousness before you know it.
All right.
Bye.
Keep up the pirating, kid. I'm rooting for you.
We have to get into the Club 41, but I don't remember how.
This Morgan Le Fay pirate.
Oh, Ash wanted me to ask if Crow could watch something with Malik, I guess.
Three vowels. Get him while they're vowed.
Alphabet.
Which
sale.
I guess is up to
three
you.
Three vowels while supplies last.
Alphabet sale. What do I do with the U? I genuinely do not remember the first thing you do with the U.
Get him while they're vowels.
Oh, the anchor chain's gonna take me up onto the screaming narwhal.
Welcome aboard, sir.
Ben Winslow? What are you doing here?
If it's all right with you, Captain, I'd like to stay aboard as your first mate.
I don't know. I really don't.
Jolly good, sir. You won't regret it, mark my words. Now, if you'll excuse me, I believe some of my stitches have popped. I'll meet you here if the winds ever change.
It truly be like that sometimes. Alright, what do we got on this ship? I don't.
I'll sleep when I'm dead. Or later tonight.
Glad that's just the recurring remark.
That's the main mast of the Screaming Narwhal. Or main tree. Hey, it's one of those spiffy new Hungarian easy action cannons I've been begging Elaine to let me buy.
Jeez!
Whoa, the wind's really doing a number on that cannonball.
Alright, cheese time.
A cheese wheel. Monster. Yeah. Still, maybe I'll find some starving rats who will eat it.
Cheese wheels, weirdly, also a staple of this game?
There'll be plenty of time for frolicking in the ship's hold later. That's a tightly sealed barrel of tar, used for patching up cracks and hazing bosuns.
A map.
It's a detailed map of the entire Gulf of Melange. This thing will come in handy if I ever get off this Verschlingener Island.
Verschlingener. Guybrush. You might have noticed, Guybrush Big Dork. Also basis of my personality. That is a sock, which might have a Club 41 membership card
in
there.
Sock.
Yes.
Club 41, probationary member number 37, Reginald Van Winslow. This should come in handy.
Time to go get into Club 41. Okay.
jerk would do that.
I don't know, but when I find the scupper scraper, I'll shove one of me bottles so deep up his fundament. Arr!
What's a fundament?
I don't know what a fundament is either. Real fear. Real fundament hours. Alright, time for some cheese-based fun.
I know what would cheer up these gruesome carvings. Cheese! Nope. Still menacing. Oh, and now my cheese wheel is staring at me.
And let me kill this man.
Arr, Pink Pajama Pierre, you foiled me plans for the last time. Prepare to meet your maker in the ebon depths of the inky sea.
Sacre bleu, is this the end of Pink Pajama Pierre?
I guess it's true. Black really is slimming.
And where I grabbed him by the eyes, he is no longer...
Pink Pajama Pierre looks a little more menacing in inky black pajamas, but he still needs some accessorizing.
He looks like a ninja now. I was trying to mispronounce ninja, but you can't.
Card?
Card?
You can't mispronounce the letter J.
Card. Here you go.
Very good, Captain Van Winslow. Here's your blindfold.
Blindfold?
Come now, sir. You know the rules. All probationary Club 41 members must wear blindfolds inside the club.
Right.
Oh, true. There's only one way to mispronounce ninja, and it's the bad way.
Very good, sir. Find the step.
I've heard you make a mean bragatini.
Get out! Nachos!
I'm so sorry.
Sorry. Ow!
Get him!
Ow!
Oof! Out for his hand!
You took the hand off me, you cracker croaker!
What a fight! That was spectacular, Driftwood! Best pirate brouhaha I've seen in months!
I don't know what got into me. It was like my hand was possessed or something.
Possessed, you say? Sounds like there may be a follow-up story there. Keep feeding me these boffo pirate stories, Threepwood. I'll be handing over the secrets of Deep Cut before you know it.
All right. Now I can... Ooh, squishy blood-red carpet, you say? Why? Why would you make that noise?
What the? You put one of those miniature swords with an olive in my grogatini. I hate those things.
Now we have a tiny sword. I can give this tiny sword to my boy. Oh, great. Create a better boy.
Between the cool black tights and the dangerously pointy accessory, Pajama Pants Pierre is starting to look halfway collectible.
Hey.
Alright, and now we can go here to the buried treasure. We are all used the word Pupsy.
Dark Ninja Dave with Killer Katana Cutlass waits stealthily for famed out of shape pirate hunter Joaquin D'Oro to find him.
What do we got to say about this now?
No one notices that I've re-gifted this buried treasure spot.
Alright, back to the jungle entrance. And now we are going to go get the treasure hunter to find him.
Hello again.
Hi.
Stop doing that.
The game gets neater once you get off Flotsam, I'm pretty sure.
I think your map isn't
but the fact that I have to
all.
Say that,
it isn't?
Probably not a
I
good
never
omen.
Found anything with it.
You must have been reading it wrong. Here, follow me.
And X marks the spot.
See? I told you I could find it.
Huh? I better start digging. It's not as deep as the other ones. Madre de Dios! Dark Ninja Dave! With Killer Karate Katana! Dark Ninja Dave! Dark Ninja Dave! Finally! The full set of porcelain power pirates is mine! All mine!
Ow! I got dirt in my eye.
My ears deceive me, or did that portly pirate just dig up a buried treasure?
He sure did, with a little help from Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
Well, that's fantastic. We haven't had a good buried treasure story in weeks. You know, Threepwood, you've got spunk. Pirate spunk.
Ew.
Now, why don't you take a walk with me back to the Keel Hollow? Tell me a little
bit
more about yourself.
Wish I had pirate spunk.
Well, it all started back on Melee Island. And that's how I wound up here on Flotsam Island.
Well, I don't know how you did it, Seapwood. But thanks to you, I've got enough sorted swashbuckling stories to keep the Flotsam Keel Hollow Gazette afloat for months. That'll show those bozos over at the Times.
Yeah, that's, great. Now, about Deep Gun.
My pleasure, Creepwood. Sit tight while I make you a copy.
Copy?
Tammy, give me a copy of the Deep Gun file. Pronto. Right away, Mr. Nipperkin. Here you go, kid. Everything you need to know to contact Deep Gun. Don't let anyone know I gave this to you, okay? My editor will put me on deep cover in the obituary beat. Catch my drift?
Not really, but...
Great! Now, if you'll excuse me, Ace reporter Davey Nipperkin's got some headlines to grab.
Finally! Now I can ask this Deep Gun person how to get off this island and back to Elaine. Seems simple enough.
Got it. In this auditory and narrative downbeat, Crow was wondering if Malik would like to watch something with him, which I was running by you to get your take on that. Where is the hut? The creepy shack. Here we go. So yeah, so what's going on there? Door time, baby.
What's the word?
It's deadline.
Deadline.
Who was the doorman? Do we get to see the doorman? Oh.
Welcome, Guybrush.
The voodoo lady! Boy, am I glad to see you! I've got so many questions!
There'll be time enough for questions later. But first, hand me the LeChuck Slayer.
The what?
The cursed cutlass of Kaflu. Now that LeChuck has been destroyed, the cutlass must be ritually dismantled.
Oh, sorry, yeah, Voodoo Lady, very good. She's a recurring character.
Evil never reawakens.
Yeah, about that.
Also, her music good.
I tried to destroy LeChuck with the cutlass, but I had to make some last-second substitutions, and there were some complications.
What manner of complications?
Well, the cutlass didn't so much annihilate LeChuck as it turned him human.
What?
I couldn't believe it either. Personally, I think it's untrue.
The human LeChuck. This is troubling.
Can you help me?
I'll do as much as the fates allow, but I fear that you will not like what I have to say.
Alright, how do I get off Flotsam?
Can you help me get off Flotsam Island? I've got a ship, but it won't do me any good with these crazy winds.
The cards say no.
No? Can't you just wiggle your fingers and voodoo schmoodoo the winds to blow out?
What you ask is beyond my power, Guybrush.
Then what in the name of Satan's comb over are you good for, you bloated old sea hag?
What was that?
That was the pox of LeChuck.
Who the what now?
The pox of LeChuck. When your improperly enchanted cutlass turned LeChuck into a human, all the evil voodoo juju within him had to go somewhere. Were you touching him at the time?
I was. Does that explain the antisocial behavior and the crude gestures?
Yes, Some of LeChuck's evil has seeped into your hand.
Do you have a cure?
No, but I know where you can find one.
I feel a piratey quest coming on.
To eliminate the pox of LeChuck, you must seek out La Esponja Grande.
The big sponge?
La Esponja Grande is no ordinary sponge, Treepwood. It is a legendary sea sponge with incredible voodoo exfoliating abilities, capable of absorbing limitless quantities of voodoo mojo.
Where can I find it?
I have never seen it myself, but a former friend of mine, Coronado de Cava, spent many years searching for it. I last saw him in the Jerkbait Islands. Take this locket to him, and tell him I vouched for your character.
I'll get right on it after I find Elaine.
That would be unwise, Guybrush. The pox of LeChuck must be eliminated before it spreads.
Whatever.
Is Elaine alright?
Can you tell me if Elaine is okay?
The view is hazy. Ask again later.
Later? But she could be in danger, or dead, or worse.
I only know what the spirits reveal, Guybrush Treepwood.
How do I get rid of the
pox? Do you have anything to stave off the pox of LeChuck? This hand is really starting to annoy me.
The only way to safely deal with the pox is La Esponja Grande.
Oh no. I've just remembered a very important narrative device in this game. Where is LeChuck?
You can't tell me about Elaine. Can you at least tell me where LeChuck is?
Without a mark of the voodoo on him, LeChuck's whereabouts are a mystery to me.
Tell me about this big sponge.
Assuming that I do go looking for La Esponja Grande after I get off this island, what else can you tell me about it?
It's a giant, magical sea sponge capable of absorbing immense voodoo energies. If there's anything that can mop up all of LeChuck's evil mojo, it's the sponge.
Got it. What is about this
Tell
locket?
Tell me more about this locket.
It was given to me by my friend, Coronado de Cava.
Why do you keep putting dramatic pauses around friend? Was Coronado...
Yes. He was my boyfriend.
Icky.
We met in the Jerkbait Islands many years ago. I fell in love with his treasure-hunting mind and his beautiful eyes. He fell in love with my voodoo charms and my supple...
La 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 la, not listening!
Like a volcano! But after several months of ocean steaming passion, our love cooled after he became obsessed with the myth of La Esponja Grande. When we parted, he gave me that locket.
Sad and disquietingly graphic.
What is her name?
You know, you've been helping me out for years, and I still don't know your name.
Names have power, Guybrush Treepwood. Only a fool willingly gives it away.
Does my name have power?
Sure, why not?
Well, this has been disturbing, but I've got an island to escape, a wife to find, and apparently a giant voodoo-sucking sponge to hunt.
May the fates guide you, Guybrush Treepwood.
That's me. That's a big mood. Alright, let's talk to this parrot skeleton.
Knock, knock.
Guybrush, don't.
Who's there?
No.
It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
You fool.
What?
I've spent months crafting a pirate parrot of Petaluma, and you've ruined it before it was finished. Now I'll have to start all over.
Don't know why that audio doesn't play. Anyways. Our parrot now.
Hey, if you're done with this, can I have it?
Fine. It's of no use to me now.
Alright, Ash is setting up a rabbit, and then y'all can do what you're doing.
World.
But until that, until then, James.
Whitey Pirate.
James time. And then I'll join folks for rabbit, I guess.
It's locked.
Yes, and it will remain locked until it's ready to reveal its secrets many moons from now.
It's a mysterious chest that I won't be opening in this episode. Frozen chicken gizzard, frozen newt eyes, snake venom popsicles.
Oh, let me check that interesting bottle.
What's this?
Okay.
Ah, the spirits have guided you well. That is a bottle containing an ancient scroll left behind by the Vakalians, the former inhabitants of Flotsam Island.
Ancient scroll, huh? Do you think it can tell me anything about these messed up winds?
Perhaps, but first, you'll have to figure out how to break the unbreakable bottle I've sealed it in.
Unbreakable bottle? Why would you do that?
Some secrets are too dangerous to fall into mortal hands, Threepwood.
Anything else you want to tell me about this scroll in the bottle?
I purchased the scroll from a bitter old pirate named Magee. Make of that what you will.
That sounds like a joke. Murray? Murray is in this game. Okay, we will get to introduce you to Murray. Who is...
What's this?
That is a shrine to Noor Trapleague, keeper of the crossroads.
Yeah, Murray was a skeleton pirate you fought in, like, the third game and decapitated very quickly, so now he's just a skull.
Did you use all the magical gunk in these bottles to cure my hand?
The pox of LeChuck can only be cured with La Esponja Grande.
That really puts the die in diorama.
Hand lotion helps.
International House of Mojo brand hand lotion. Good for removing warts, curses, hexes, and unsightly buboes. Warning, not for use against poxes, especially the pox of LeChuck. Rats.
Here's the closet.
Wonder what's in-
Don't touch that! It's where I keep my unmentionables.
The joke itself, not great. The changing item descriptions, extremely blessed. Here we go.
Guess this thing fell off the roof when I had my little LeChuck episode. I should get shouty more often. Looks like the wind gods of Flotsam are pointing that way.
Here's our next puzzle, which is follow the winds. Oh, wait.
Hey there, Threepwood. You mind if I get your pirate on the street opinion about the Death Cloud?
Death Cloud? Pox of LeChuck.
Oof.
The Pox of LeChuck? Pox of LeChuck. Two on the nose, not a pizzazz. Death Cloud is punchy. More in your face, more. Ooh, I'm gonna die. Well, I got sick pirates to interview. See ya!
Yeah, so this game is kicked off now, and it's getting just, in my opinion,
unicorns.
Notably better.
Get your hand
this dude doesn't look good.
Oi, so you are.
What can you tell me about this bottle?
Arr, that'd be one of me special unbreakable bottles.
Unbreakable? Ah! There isn't a bottle alive that's a match for my gift for destruction. Impressive.
The sacred ingredients are those jagged crystal reefs. They're tougher than diamonds.
Weird. But what do you do if you want to open one of these unbreakable bottles in order to, say, look at an ancient scroll you've cleverly sealed inside?
Arr, that's a good question, lad. Here, show you how it's done.
Oh yeah, he's got an unbreakable bottle breaker. Also, after this, we got a rabbit.
To chip off flakes from the reefs to crack open bottles like this one.
me get this straight. Your unbreakable bottles are, in fact, opened by breaking them?
Don't get cute, Blandy. I break other things too, you know.
So there's his thing. And he freaks out if we break his thing. So we will be doing that as soon as the supernatural experience is over. I will save... that's an autosave that I guess is always... Yeah, that's always just an autosave. That's nice that you can't save over the autosave. Alright. And we will resume this whenever works best, because it's fun and I enjoy doing it. And I hope you do as well. See you on the rabbit, friend.